Follow the length of a footpath, and you will find yourself walking in the steps of your ancestors. The footpath is the oldest of all man-made structures. Their narrow meandering lines, etched in the ground by the feet of countless people, are found the world over. The footpath is an expression of the human desire for travel, to explore, and to trade. In Bukovlia, this footpath serves as a crucial shortcut to the river and beyond to the station in Zvechai. Many footpaths later became tracks the width of a horse and cart, like this one. Its narrow single lane reflects a village life in the past that moved at a far gentler pace. The main village road can be found lower down, but it seems evident from the way it twists and turns that it was originally a footpath that followed the natural contours of the land. At our end of Bukovlia, the track here was recently asphalted. But as it only served a few houses, there was little need to widen it, and it more or less kept the original shape. Elsewhere in the village, the widening of the road from the pontoon bridge to the fire station has been planned for quite a while. Markers have been pegged into the ground, and are a portent for what is to come. It somehow seems illustrative of the increasing speed of life in the village and creeping urbanization, that it will be widened where possible to the width of two cars. Hedgerows will be ripped up, trees felled, rocks shattered and broken up for aggregate. And there will be corners cut from a number of gardens. Where the road had twisted before, it is being straightened. Some of the preparation work has been done by the village community itself. At a crucial junction, a retaining wall is being built to give the road additional space and to make negotiating the turning easier. Winter has passed, and work has finally resumed. The machines have come to life again, and a further layer of aggregate is laid and compacted where the road is uneven. The asphalt paver, having had its hopper filled by a truck with a mixture of aggregate and the binding agent, bitumen, proceeds to move ahead slowly. All the while, this mixture is conveyed to the back of the machine, and distribution augers spread the asphalt outward to a width determined by the operator. The machine crawls over the crushed rock and leaves behind a black snail trail of road. A sharp smell of molten tarmac peppers the air. Following on from this, the rollers ride up and down, compacting the road while the material is still hot. Thank you. the new road has a hard edge and a deep shine to its blackness. But this will be tempered over time. The hedgerows will be replanted, and everything will soften. And then, no one will remember how the road once looked, or consider that beneath the tarmac was once a track that originated from a footpath. But look closely, and the original shape will reveal itself.